Good evening, ladies and gents, and all of you watching at home. It's Super Squid once again with Amigos Racing Team for the finale of the Amigos TCR Touring Car Championship. You find yourselves in the commentary booth temporarily with Langster, who's guesting with us tonight, and our race host, Chris RP90. Langster, Chris, if you guys want to say hi.
Evening.
Hi, everyone. How are you doing?
All good, you?
Yeah, good, thank you.
It's good to hear you back on the microphone once again. Chris, have you got anything to say regarding the previous race and this one and what's coming up next? Take it away.
Absolutely no reports from the last race, to be honest, mate. It's been very, very clean. There's been no incidents that are actually reported, let alone to be looked at and then thrown out. So, well done to all the guys, really, keeping it clean and keeping it close. I said this is the last round of this current TCR season. There will be a season two going forward where we could be potentially running teammates as well as individual championships. So yeah, it should be interesting if we can get it all put together. But I imagine that will be on Gran Turismo 7 if they sort the lobbies out and not GT Sport. But we'll see how things go. After this series has finished, we're going to have a week break, and then we're going to be starting a Carrera Cup, which will be 7 weeks, using the GR3 911s. So yeah, if you fancy having a go, the Discord link is in the description. Come and sign up, come and have a go, see how you get on.
I can only echo that as well, that we've got leagues for everybody, no matter what your, you know, pick your poison. If you're into your LMPs, or your Group 3s, or your road cars, I've got a league count myself every Friday of August, which will be a randomised road car I make specially for you guys as well. So that'll be a league you might be interested in, but there's something for everyone and anyone here at Amigos Racing Team. And again, I think big thank you to Chris and to all of our partners who've teamed up with us and supplied little goodie bags as well for our participants. Really thank you for having you on board and for providing what you've provided. And hopefully a bit of free advertising for you guys won't go amiss either. And a big thank you as well on top of that to Chris for putting together such a successful tournament. It's been really spectacular to commentate on, and I can only wish you the best of success with the Porsche one as well, mate.
Cheers. And I just want to say congratulations to Quinny for winning the championship. It is by a country mile, and we've been trying to hold him back, trying to peg him back, trying to make it really, really even. But it's just everything we've thrown at him, he's just coped with so well, and he deserves the victory, to be honest. But also a shout out to the rest of the drivers, to be honest, as well, because we've all raced really, really cleanly and really fairly. Yes, there's been a couple of bumps and incidents on the way, but it's touring cars, isn't it? You expect a bit of contact. So, yeah, well done to everyone.
Well, in that case, Chris, if you want to head over to sorting out your final races for tonight, have a quick catch up with the boy Langster.
Yeah, good luck tonight, Langs, in your race as well. I will hopefully watch along later on.
Good luck to you, Chris.
Yeah, good luck, Chris. Cheers, mate.
Right, well, Langster, we find ourselves tonight at Dragon Trail Gardens, at the reverse layout featuring the double right-hander at the start, the Hexagon of Death. Is this a particular favourite of yours? Because I definitely cannot stand it.
I'll be honest, this is probably my least favourite circuit on the game. Although I'm quite fast around here, you've got the Chicane of Death as well. The left-handed hexagon is just so troublesome. You've got to be so smooth and so precise. You've got to sort of take it as a triple apex as you go around the left-hand corner and come out right halfway through, then take another two apexes before you can get back on the power. But if you mess it up, you'll end up in the barrier on the far right hand side. And I believe we just watched Matthew Barnes go through the other Chicane of Death. Mad lad on the pad as he goes through there, I can see. But yeah, good luck to all the guys. Congratulations to Quinny on actually winning the event. He's going to step up into the Big Boys League in the ART Championships from next week on GT7. So that's going to be quite interesting to see him on track and actually race him, see how he gets on. And so good luck to the rest of the guys. And thanks everyone for joining in the TCR and watching along with us. Good luck with your commentary this evening, Squid.
Oh, cheers, Lang. So I think echoing what you're saying there, knowing that that Quinny, as we run a ball with him just for a little bit then, as he will be stepping up into our main series on the Monday night. So it really is, here at Amigos, a means of progression that these guys started at, without any disrespect, in the very bottom of the pecking order, putting on some real display of learning how to race properly, race fairly, sensibly, cleanly, and push their limits. And they really have all progressed, all blossomed. heading into this TCR league, and as you said, I think Quinny is going to be a real advertisement for the progression league, as it were.
But for sure, definitely.
I think thanks well for you joining me for a couple of race legs. It's been really great to have your input on some of these events as well, and best of luck for whatever you're racing in tonight. And I don't want to hold you any longer than you need to.
No, cheers, thank you. I'm just doing one of the practice races for the championship, as it were, for both tiers of drivers, basically, in one race. So it's going to be a learning curve for everyone. A bit like, obviously, TCR with the Progression League as well, a learning curve for everyone. This is just a preview race tonight that we're doing at two different circuits, just to basically get alongs, so everyone gets to meet each other before we start the season, which is season 9, I believe. But good luck tonight, and good luck to all the drivers.
Cheers, thanks, Dad. Have a good evening yourself, buddy. Take care.
Cheers, my man. Catch you later.
See you around. Well, and I think Hocker's in the comments there saying thanks for putting on a great series, and again, brilliant commentary. Well, Hocker's, I can only say thank you very much for being far too kind. But I think it's about time I let Chris know that we're good to go. And hopefully we'll be underway in a moment. I can't see though, where am I? The cursor has gone. Let's try that one instead. Yeah, Chris can do it. Good. So then, thanks for the comments there. Thanks to Chris for putting the league on. Good luck to everyone in the race. Also, I hope they're all going to do really well. As summed up there by Lancaster, Gina Quinney did indeed win the championship outright at the previous event. So now he's just putting on maybe a triple length victory lap for us this evening. But the fight is still to be played for second and third place. If I remember off the top of my head, I believe it is Mad Lad on a Pad and Mr. Tiddlywink are really very closely fighting for those podium positions. I'll see if I can find the leaderboard quickly, just while I'm scrolling through here. And it looks like, indeed, yes, Mr. Tiddlywink is only 5 points behind Mad Lad on a Pad for P2 and 3. So it really is all to play for. And if these two have any particularly big incidents and find themselves at the back of the pack, it could well be Nene jumping up from P4. So there's a lot to be going on tonight. We're looking really at Mad Lad, Tiddlywink and Nene, who we find ourselves thinking maybe second, third and fourth last respectively. Indeed they are. We've got Nalinski in the chat there saying good luck everybody. Thanks to Shuni Nalinski, I'm glad you joined the show. We're going to jump on board, I think, from the back of the pack as normal with our current championship winner, Gina Quinney, 61. Get the start from his point of view. We've got our 5 red lights. And away they go. There's a BMW moving very slowly on the start there. I think that might be Chris in his new livery, the grey BMW on the left. See, they're going about 2 or 3 wide into the first corner here. Let's see, Quinny's going for a very early look at the inside of Mr. Tiddlywink there. He's just about given way. It looks like Sergeant Cullen had to go very wide at the start of that one. If we jump back on board there with Quinny, it looks like everyone has made it through in one piece. I believe it was Dalton who started in first place, but now it looks like Matthew Francis has taken that away from Dalton, finds himself down in P4. And J-Lad going very wide there through the first corner. So through the first apex there, through the hexagons. Still keeps P3 though, so he's doing very well there. So I think we're going to run on board there with J-Lad. His reverse camera, his fate and Francis seem to have gotten away already by a second and then some. So the battle here, you see trailing behind Jay, we've got Dalton in fourth, Chris Chow in fifth, Nene in sixth, Mad Lad's already found his way up to seventh, Sergeant Cullen going through a very late move, oh, serious contact there, and Cullen is around. That's not worked out well for him at all. If we jump back down the pack very quickly, you can see here, I think he slightly forced his way past Mad Lad on the pad, and actually that's put him into a complete spin. Let's see what's happened there with Sergeant Cullen. So we're on board here with the man in the Mazda. He's got a good exit there over on Chris Ivy 90. He's used a little bit more of the track than I think he should have done, but I think he's just too late in the brakes. He's indeed way too late in the brakes. Straight to the side of Mad Lad and Nene, and then Mad Lad comes around for the revenge move. And unfortunately, he's just got nowhere to go. Mad Lad quite fairly decides to give him a chance to catch back up, but that may well be Mad Lad losing some points to Tiddlywink before he even gets any momentum. Tiddlywink up into P6, if we jump aboard with him quickly. So he's made a really good start on lap one there. He has, however, got Nene just lurking behind him. These two may well be fighting for third place. in the championship if it comes, if push comes to shove. So we have to see how these two get on over the length of the stream tonight. Right now, though, it is disastrous fate in the Scirocco. Tim goes very wide there. He just about cut me off, but he's still running wide. Sideways in the BMW, huge drift. Side swipes into Chris R390. Gina Quinn has to take evasive action as well. But fortunately, they seem to come out mainly unscathed. That's a huge loss of traction there for Tillery. So you can see what's happened again there. And he's just put the grass there, put his foot down, but quite wisely keeps his foot out of the throttle for with any more collecting of other drivers. Down to P8 though, he's got to get a move on. I may have cursed him there. Cursed the commentator. Puts him down to P8. Again, just teetering above Madler there, 2.5 seconds away. As we said, though, fate though, he's starting to run away. In the Scirocco, he's got the medium tyres on. You're going to need that extra longevity in the tyres in the front-wheel drive Scirocco, as I'm sure Will Dalton in the Audi TT down in P5. But as we scroll through now in the lap 2, fate leads in P1. And we've got J-Lad still holding P2, so good effort from him there. Matthew Francis in P3, Chris Char in 4, and we'll be gaining on that Subaru down the straight as I ride aboard then with Chris Char. There might be a move heading into turn 1. If we're going to see any crazy iRacing grass dipping here, but we'll see Chris Char throwing that green Lexus to the inside, and he will take P3 from Matthew Francis. A bit of a nudge on the exit there, maybe trying to get a move and make sure he don't lose any more time to the leaders, but he will take P3. I don't think Matthew Francis really has much to answer with as they head down the long straight opposite the pits. Going very aggressive there, throwing it into the corner, catching right onto the tail there of JLab 1970 in the BMW. So that might be the real forte here of the Lexus, heading through that quadruple left-hander there, the hexagon as we like to call it. As we're saying, Matthew Francis is in P4. He's got a small air gap back to ART Owen Dalton there in P5. He's opted for the softer tyres here, so maybe trying to use his advanced grid position to make some gains. But he has unfortunately made some losses, having started from P1, finds himself in P5 as Chris Char runs a little wide there. Matthew Francis now back up the inside. We'll run aboard there with Dalton as we have a front row seat of the drag race. As expected though, the Lexus easily sweeps past the Subaru there. And resumes P3. Matthew Francis having a quick look up the inside, but to no avail. Now this chicane here, Langston mentioned the chicane of death. They haven't just got one at the seaside, they've got one at the Gardens too. And those enormous sausage curbs serving to just launch the cars up into the air if you get the apex wrong. And it really is a fine game of the margins here, because you can cut across the top of it and gain a penalty, or you might just about run over the top unscathed. You might put one wheel over it and get sent into the shadow realm. There's an unending list of possibilities here, but Dalton has made it through in one piece. Chris R390 up into P6, got a large gap inside of him there. Tilly Big and Mad Lad are going side by side into turn 1. Mad Lad will go up the inside of Tilly Big. Tilly looking for a cutback there on the exit, but just not happening for the time being. It was a smart drive there, Tilly Big, very astute awareness there, knowing that Mad Lad was going to go up the inside, but he just couldn't get the grip on the cutback to take him down the back straight. To be a little bit steady though, going through his Chris R390 overhead in P6 has gone very wide, and J-Lad is in the wall. That's a very unsafe rejoin, and he spins there, heading out of the last apex there, and he's put it in the middle of the track. Oh, goodness me, that's very close from J-Lad. What exactly has happened to him here? So as we're riding on board with J-Lad, let's see, he was in P2. There's nothing in that there from Chris Char. I think he's just not broken there. He's hitting all the buttons, it seems, and forced into a spin as we ride outside of J-Lad. Chris Arthur just about dodges it, as does Mad Lad and Tiddywink, and he rejoins. It's a little bit more wheel spin, and Gina Quinney's almost collected there. Oh my goodness, very, very close. That could have been a real mountain of trouble there for Gina Quinney. Someone who doesn't seem to be in too much trouble though is this man here, Disastrous Fate, leading by just over 3/4 of a second there from Chris Char. We can see him go for one more lap as Chris Char dives into the pits. Matthew Francis also doing the same. Dalton's going to stick it out for one more lap though, so we've got two front wheel drive cars leading, admittedly at a 4-second gap between them more or less. Chris R390 up into P3 now. his redesigned livery there. That really nice black fade into grey looks lovely. Mad Lad on the paddle looking for a very eager move up the inside, but nothing happening there. He will keep P4. Just behind him there, we've got Mr. T-Wick now. He's fallen off the back there of Mad Lad and now into the clutches of Nene. It's runnable with Nene as he follows Mr. T-Wick through this quadruple left panel, through the first apex there, through the second. Tillyman's run wide again onto the red edging of the track there. Nene, oh, he shoved him out a little bit wide, but I think in that context, really rubbing his racing. Nene will take P5 from Tillyweek. So that is Mr. Tillyweek there down into P6, and he's going to dive into the pits on this next lap. I think he's running dangerously low on fuel. Giannacquini up into P7. But again, we know that two drivers pitted and one driver unfortunately made a bit of an accident there. It was J-Lad, as Matthew Francis died in the pits as well. Colon also going to the pits there earlier, so he is in P10 after his pit stop, but going in for about three quarters of the field on soft tyres, so he'll be going quite aggressive for these next 10 minutes at least. Let's run on board though. We're behind Chris Arfinati, who's made a move on Dalton there. And Mallard on the pad is looking for some of the action as well. We'll jump on back there with Chris Arfinati. We're going to see him jump into the pits any moment now. He is left it very late, as has Mallard and Dalton. Nene is going to stick it out for one more lap though. So this will put Nene into the effective lead of the race, maybe for one lap at least. But it looks like he might well have it covered. He's sticking it out. If he can hold on for the rest of this lap and not run out of fuel, as a Quinny here, tyre squealing coming from him there. He's got slightly less fuel. We know Quinny tends to go very long on these medium tyres, but it seems that Nene is running the same strategy. He might be with a good chance of keeping a podium place and crucially keeping Mr. Tiddywink out of the running. So we'll see now, disastrous fate will move up into P3 after his pit stop. Chris Charles, 2 seconds down the road in P4. Chris Arfinati is 2 seconds down the road, sorry, in P5. And then we've got a train of three cars here with Mad Lad, Matthew Francis, and OM Dalton winning at the pits at more or less the same time. Mad Lad widening the entry of that corner here. Matthew Francis making from the inside, semi-attacking, semi-defending. Dalton has to jump on the brake to avoid a collision with the white Subaru. Looks like they're going to make it through in one piece, which is always great to see. Dalton earlier on the breakthrough, so Francis very late has compromised his run into this S complex here, but Dalton cannot find a way past for the time being. Let's have a look on the outside. No dice there. And we know that Audi is going to be very nimble through the corners. Matthew Francis again letting the brake. You see Dalton maximising first gear, really putting his foot down. Now they're side by side heading down the back straight. We'll jump aboard with Sergeant Colon, as he's going to have an excellent view of this drag race along the back section of Dragon Trail Gardens. Dalton is on the inside now. He should have this one sewn up. Matthew Francis trying to hold it around the outside. Dalton there being launched by a sausage curve. Matthew Francis takes 7th place. Back from Dalton, does he? Oh, he's hanging around the outside. Fantastic driving from the pair of them. And again, here at Amigos, what we really pride ourselves on, some courteous and respectful driving, exactly what you've seen from this battling pair here. Dalton knows wrong, very wide in the exit, and oh, it's like just a bit of a bump there from Sergeant Colon instead of sneaking his way past. And Giannacquini has finally dived into the pits there from his medium tyres, as did Nene from the lead. Sergeant Colon going very aggressive there to defend from Dalton. Matthew Francis is running extremely wide, they're almost three wide out of turn two there. And we'll go on jump aboard and stay with Mr. Tillyweek, I think, as all these guys are fighting in front of him. The last thing he wants to be losing time to Nene. He's 5 seconds behind, having just pitted, but he needs to get past these guys. He wants to secure a chance at the podium spots. Oh, he's just run wide, unfortunately. Oh, it hurts for Tillyweek. Just trying to find a way around the outside of Dalton, but that's not the place to do it. And he's been very slow, and there goes Quinny and Nene passing down to P10. Tillyweek with engine damage as well. That's the last thing we want to see from the man in the BMW fighting for third place in the championship. I should say it was fighting for second place, but he may well now be fighting for third, because Nelly's going to have some 3 points on him at this rate. That's really throwing a spanner in the works for Mr. Tillyweek. We go back to the front of this battling pack, where Mallard on the pad is up into P3. He's on soft tyres, so he's going to have to fight aggressively for this one. Speaking of aggressive, Chris R390 really catching up onto the back of him there in P4 in the BMW. Let's see what a BMW's got in a straight line. Mad Lad takes a half second penalty there for track limits, maybe taking too much of the sausage curbs. Heading through that final chicane. Now we see the BMW really trying to stretch its legs on that Evo. However, it looks like Mad Lad had a slightly better exit through the final corner. It's just eking out a couple of hundredths a second there as they head over the finish line into turn one. You can see it was a 9-tenth gap, now a full second, now a second and 3-tenths as Mad Lad widens that corner to great effect, and a great run out of the last corner there as well for turn two. You see, in fact, Chris has lost about half a second from the bottom of the straight to the top, so he's really able to learn the better line through that corner. If you look back in the distance, though, Sergeant Colon has now stepped up from Dalton and Matthew Francis to take P5. Dalton and Matthew Francis are almost going side by side into the hexagon section there. Very dangerous game they're playing here. Nene down in P8, he's 2 seconds up on Gina Quinney. But no, Quinney's starting at the back of the pack. To stay within keeping distance, touching distance of Nene is no mean feat, especially with his traction control penalty. So Nene, I think, is going to be the one to watch here. He's going to be proved to be the caught in the bottle against Gina Quinney, sorry. Can he gain some points up on Mr. Tilly, who we saw at that unfortunate incident earlier, and that J-Lad spun at more or less the same place, albeit with a little bit more of a spectacular re-entry to the track, so he's not had the best run of things for the first of tonight's races. But again, we've still got two more shots at this, so maybe J-Lad will find his momentum in rounds two and three. Seems things are still kicking off though in the chicane just behind Chris R390. We have a look at the ball with Sergeant Colon. He's 1.4 seconds away from Dalton, who is still battling with Matthew Francis. We'll jump on board then with Dalton, see how he views the golden blue Subaru. Almost like an inverted colour scheme with that iconic 555 livery that Colin McRae was so famous for. You see the Subaru in the slipstream just gaining for a second there, but I think losing out to the Audi eventually just through the sheer lack of weight inside the TT. Gaining on the entry though, you see that the forward drive really helped to keep that car stable, but on the exit, the lighter Audi does start to pull away. What Dalton has to be careful of, you can see in the bottom left of the screen, is he's starting to chew through those soft tyres. He's got to make them last for at least another 5 minutes. That will be hard though, especially if he's stamping on the accelerator out of these corners using second gear, where the wheels will be just scrambling for traction like a kid in a sweet shop. But he's just not going to make the loss if he drives as aggressively. He's got to be a little bit easier on his tyres. You see there, Matthew Francis has now reeled him back in by about half a second, and there could be more to play for as they head into this tight right hand hairpin. See, is it going to be a move on Matthew Francis? Oh, there's a very late move. It's not the move he was hoping to make, I don't think. So he's got to be very careful. It's not the way to go about it. He has given back some of that time, but now he's inviting Nene into the battle. You can see he's catching just outside the slipstream for the time being, but he may well be with a shot at P6. We'll jump aboard then with Nene for a moment as he follows these two through the final chicane, avoiding the sausage curb. At least the first one, just about avoiding the second one. Needs to widen that left-hander, get back across the right-hand side. Matthew Francis is now taking a half-second penalty, as we saw a Mad Lad take earlier. Now feathering the front to him mainly as he goes to pick that apex, watch nice and wide, and he's gaining it. Now he's definitely within the slipstream, maybe even a double slipstream here. Matthew Francis moving to the right-hand side to serve his penalty. Very sportsmanlike, and that should give Nene P7 without too much of a fight. Matthew Francis was breaking late there, maybe just to try and cut off Gina Quinney, but Nene will move it into P7, crucially, the car between him and Quinney to give him a couple extra points there. Looking at the front of the pack though, it seems disastrous fate has been reeled in by Chris Chai. Indeed he has, jumping aboard then with the man in the Scirocco. The Lexus is really catching up onto the back of the front wheel drive car here, and you can see having to defend there from Chris Chai, compromise his line through that little S complex, and Malin on a pad is lurking in the background there as well. We see Exhaustious Fate breaking there, but Chris Chai gave him a little bit of contact, urged him a little bit wide, ushered him towards the apron of the track there, and Chris Chai moves up into the lead. But Madame Lapad is not going to be too far behind. We can jump on board with him if I can get the front camera this time. We see Exhaustious Fate has that even lined up to retaliate down the back straight. I don't think he does. Maybe he's saving to keep the slipstream caught the pit straight. Let's jump aboard with these two at the front then instead. Disastrous Fate having to keep tight to that left-hander to wash through, but you can hear the tyres just dying there for some grip, really screaming there to try and get some purchase on the track. And still understeering as he heads through the final corner. He's not even on full throttle. You can see the Lexus is much more comfortable, much more settled through that long sweeping right-hander to round off the lap, and he's just about eking some time away from the Scirocco. Pulling it back, though, as Chris Antonotti does in front, seems like a fairly early pit stop on the medium tyres. Disastrous Fate having to brake really hard in a straight line, but these mediums are not at their best anymore. And Fate there really having to lose time out there to Chris Char in the Lexus. Malaz still trying to keep him at arm's length there, not quite in the slipstream, but that could all change as they head through the hexagon. He's given some time away on the entry, but now he's going to try and pull it back on the exit. They're on very wide there, and actually it's just about balanced out, so nothing to play for through that sector of the track at least. Sergeant Coleman in P4 is doing fairly well, but you can see those front tyres on the Mazda are looking very, very aggressively worn there. That front left tyre in particular, I think, dealing with these hairpins and long right-handers. He's definitely passed his best, at least half worn, I think, in my judgment. And he's going to have to chart those off within another lap or so, I think. But fortunately, he should be able to do that for fuel anyway. So Coleman had to fill up the car just about enough for fuel, keep the tyres as healthy as he can. Quilo up into P5, he has gotten past Nene and Matthew Francis, but lots of lag here, so that's far from comfortable to watch. He is ahead of Nene though, crucially. I'm not too sure where that move occurred. Nene is still ahead of Matthew Francis. Dalton now is again trying to reel these guys in. You can see though, his soft tyres almost identical there to Matthew Francis. Not looking particularly great as Dalton has to go wide, I think. Maybe misjudged the braking zone there. And they're trying to avoid a collision. There's almost entirely avoided the corner. Scraping some gravel there on his way out of the chicane. Let's put him all out of sort. Conserve what little of the tyres he's got left as he heads around the final corner. On to the start of lap 12. Sergeant Coleman then diving into pits to get rid of his shoddy looking tyres. Chris Offrey 90 having made his pit stop on the previous lap. Looking fairly comfortable to go to the end then. Three-quarter tank of fuel, a fresh set of medium tyres. This should be a final long stint for him. Let's see that Disastrous Fate has managed to pull away from Chris Char. The answer is no. The Lexus is still there as they head out of the hexagon. So he did manage to overtake Chris, it looks like, after they passed each other about this time on the last lap. But now Mad Lad is really, really this pair, and of course this fighting is not doing him any favours trying to get away from the man in the Mitsubishi. Malad smooth on the entry there, lifting off at the apex, just let the car coast through gently, saving the tyres, and now he's got a real good view of these two as they head down the long final straightaway before the chicane and the start finish. Chris Char is on the inside, he's taking P1 at the entry, but he's gone very wide indeed. Disastrous Fate goes clean around the outside. Very smooth move there from the Polish driver. However, Chris Char is looking for another cutback on him indeed, and Mad Lad has to lift off the throttle there actually to avoid making contact with these two. However, he's right within the battle. Is anyone going to jive into the pits here? Disastrous Fate and Mad Lad are going to jump into the pits on this lap. Mad Lad, crucially, with almost 20% more fuel than Disastrous Fate, which is even comfortably undercut the Scirocco in the pit lane. Question is though, will he undercut Chris Char? See, he's got fairly worn front tyres there, but he's had to push like mad on this lap here to make sure he doesn't get beaten by Mad Lad in the pits. Gina Quinney though, you can see he's got half a tank left of fuel and a fairly fresh set of medium tyres, so I'm sure we'll see him emerge in the net lead once Chris Char makes his stop. Nene as well, he's only a second behind, so we know these two on a similar strategy may well take the podium places depending on where Chris Char emerges after his pit stop. Mad Lad's just emerged from the pits there, 11 seconds behind Nene, so that's about 12-13 seconds behind Gina Quinney. So on the soft tyres, he's going to have to gain, well, let's say if it's 1 minute 40 a lap, he's going to have to gain about 2 seconds a lap on these guys, I think, to be with a chance of taking the race win. I'm not too sure that's within his remit today, but we know Mad Lad will push as hard as he can until that checkered flag drops. Chris Offrey 90, he's going to try and hunt him down, but I think on medium tyres in the BMW, he's not going to have much to do with that Mitsubishi in P4. P5 would still be a very respectful finish for the man in BMW. Disastrous Fate jumped out the pits there in P6. You see, he lost out there to Mad Lad, having come in with no percent fuel. He's 2 seconds up on Colon, though, but 30 seconds away from Chris Char. Where is he going to emerge once Chris makes his final pit stop? We see Chris on the map there, diving into the pits now. He's got 3% fuel, so we're going to stay on board with Disastrous Fate and see whereabouts the Lexus emerges in relation to the Scirocco. He's almost thrown the Scirocco sideways there through the chicane. Tips that last apex nicely, washing wide, and now he's just got to feather that throttle, be gentle as he heads through the last right-hander here before onto the back straight. He's in fourth gear, just get a bit extra rotation in the car. And there he goes along the back straight over the start finish line. Chris Char is still in the pits. Leaving the pits now, 64% fuel. We'll see him on the left of your screen in just a second. But where is he in relation to the Scirocco? He's just ahead, it looks like. Oh, goodness me, that's a very close entry there for the Scirocco. Dos Straight will be fuming. But Chris Char might need a couple of corners to get those tyres up to temperature. And this could be where Fate makes his gains, especially heading through the hexagon complex here. Let's see how Chris handles it on his cold tyres. Webster's in the comments are saying, we're enjoying some quality clean racing. We have been enjoying that indeed. And it seems that the screaming understeer of the Scirocco is just not going to be enough to keep Chris Char within reach, who should now be catching up to the BMW of Chris R390. So while we let those guys find their rhythm, I want to quickly have a look at the battle for the lead. Gina Quinney was in the lead by 1 second, about a lap ago. You stretch that out to 1 second and 4 tenths. If you compare the fuel and the tyres, though, from Quinney to Nene, we can see they are more or less identical. So Quinney is now going to have to win this race on his pace alone and keep Nene out the slipstream. That means he has to keep some consistently clean laps, make sure he stays within the track limits, no penalties. No scrubbing the tyres too much, but Nene has really developed across the length of this series, developing his strategy, developing his tyre and fuel management, and he's really going to try and take the fight to Tiddywink and Mad Lad for those podium places. Speaking of Mad Lads, having set a fastest lap previously, a 138.4, we might well see him eclipse that one as he comes over the line, maybe not today. 1.7 off of his best lap, but I'm sure there's more left in him yet. He's going to have to catch about 2 seconds a lap. He wants a chance at winning. He has taken a second out of Nene already, but there's still more on the table, more gains he'll have to make. Chris R390 is now heading a train of a couple of cars here. We've got Chris Chai in P5, Disastrous Fate in P6, and Sergeant Colon just on the back of that there in P7. Let's jump aboard though with Chris Char as he hunts down the BMW. We've got a fresh set of soft tyres on the Lexus. Sophie Branson wishing good luck to Matthew Francis there in the comments. Let's watch on board with Chris. See if we can get maybe some cockpit cam action here. We've not had this for a while. There we go. So we're on board with Chris Char. You know the BMW is on medium, the Lexus is on soft. So really should be a foregone conclusion, providing that Chris Char keeps his tyres in one piece. Great traction out of the S-bends. He's having a look around the outside of the BMW. Chris shuts the door on him as Lance Stroll did for Vettel, the last lap of the French Grand Prix, if you're watching. But now we're going to see that pure V8 power come into play as Chris Char goes to try and make a move around Chris, R390. The BMW defends to the right-hand side. Chris Char will have to go around the left. No, Chris will resume the racing line. Let's see how these guys handle the chicane. R390 very slow to the entry there on the medium tyres. Chris Char and the Lexus having a much better time of things on the softer tyres. However, their fighting, you can see, is bringing Disastrous Fate into play. Chris Char's going to try and make his move early there on the BMW, hugging the inside line, like your favourite grandson, as Martin Brundle might say. But he will take P4. However, Chris R390 with the slipstream flashing his lights there, letting you know this battle is not over. Will he make a move back for P4? Looks like that battle is gone now. I think he's going to try and leave that one for another day. Knows he's got Disastrous Fate behind him, I think also on medium tyres, but the Scirocco is lightning quick out of the corners. Let's jump on board then with Disastrous Fate. Let's see if he's going to take the fight to the BMW. He's not quite in the slipstream as yet, but being very aggressive there on the start of the hexing hits. Chris runs very wide. I think I've thrown Disastrous Fate for a loop there. It's distracted him. Both of them scrubbing a heck of a lot of the life out of their tyres there. This is going to allow Sergeant Colon to catch up to them, hopefully. Although, having said that, if we look at his tyres, they are far from healthy. And he'd be lucky, I think, just to keep them in his windscreen, if I'm honest. As a fate looks to remove the inside of Chris R390, but nothing going for the time being there. So we'll jump back a little way down the pack. Let's see who's battling behind us. We've got Owen Dalton there in P8, Matthew Francis in P9, so Phil McFarlane cheering him on from the comments as well. Matthew Fulci having a great start to the race there, retaining the lead for a short while, but it seems that strategy just hasn't quite gone his way. It's a tricky track here at Dragon Trail Gardens, but I think none so will compare to that more than Mr. Tiddywink, who, having started very strongly, made a couple of unfortunate errors and finds himself down in P10. Same can be said of J-Lad here in P11. It's just not falling their way. We've got 2 and a bit minutes left here at our first of tonight's 3 races at Dragon Trail Seaside. It seems that Mad Lad is going to be fighting for or keeping P3, as Nene is about 4 seconds away from Gina Quinney now. So he really has run away with this one, Gina Quinney. And I see Nene having compared their tyres there on the bottom left of the screen. That's pretty, oh, that's very wide there. Nene's really been pushing hard to try and catch him, but I think that's come to his detriment. And he probably won't be seeing any more of Gina Quinney for this race at least. Mala down in P3, Chris Char in 4th. We've got a little gaggle of cars here behind Chris R390. We run on board with him then. Actually, can we get Quinney doing Quinney things? Yep, Quinney doing Winnie things, I think we should call it. Chris R390 having the fend off, and Darcy Strait and Colon. Darcy Strait defending there from the blue and black Mazda into the second sector here. This is where Chris really has to push now. Push within reason, I must be said, though, as he's not got particularly a high amount of fuel to play with. This should be enough to see him to the end of the lap. Fate defending from Sergeant Colon is going to look for another cutback there, as was Fate, it seems. But Chris is going to have got to pair them off, and now we're going to have a very interesting fight down the home straight. Although it looks like Sergeant Colon's just about missed a gear change there, and it's not going to help him if he wants to keep P5. Fate looking for over on the outside of Chris R390. He's very late on the brakes, very late indeed. He is going to make it stick though. Oh, there's a bit of door banging there as Chris R390 is forced wide. This is going to allow Sergeant Colon into the mix there. He might just have a wheel up the inside of Chris R390. It's going to be very close to the line. They are going to have one more lap, it looks like. Colon will take the inside line up on Chris, but Chris may well have the slipstream of Australia. No, he doesn't. In fact, he's going to let Sergeant Colon go. He's having to lift and coast here very heavily. I think he may well be short on fuel. You can see there, he's really being very ginger on the throttle there, shifting up earlier into 4th and 5th, so perhaps he wasn't anticipating this being their last lap, so he's going to let Sergeant Colon and Darcy Strait have their battle and hopefully keep Owen Dalton away. For the time being, though, it looks like Nene is having to defend from Mad Lad on the pad. We know he's making a huge resurgence there on his soft tyres. Quinney, 5.4 seconds up the road. This is definitely his win in the bag, as far as I can tell. But Mad Lad might well have something to say about the final podium place. That's run on board with him then. He's got a half second penalty to his name, so you have to drop that at some point before the finish line. But the question is, can he really Nene with about 3 corners to go? Let's have a look. Nene quite early on the brakes there. Mala going very late, shows a 10th of that second penalty off already in the braking zone. He's going to try and reel Nene in one last time. He's very aggressive through these final few corners, but I don't think he's going to have the chance to make a place unless Nene has a fuel disaster. We're going to wave Gina Quinney over the line for race 1 of 3. A fairly familiar sight to see him take the checkered flag for anybody else. Nene will just about keep Mad Lad at bay for P2. A great heap of points there for Nene, but Mad Lad is still in contention for P2 and may well have it sewn up, given that Tiddywink has had a disastrous one today. Not disastrous one, though, for Chris Chai in P4. And Disastrous Fate will just hold off Sergeant Colon over the line for P5 and 6, respectively. Chris R390 comes to take P7 by the skin of his teeth, running very low on fuel there. And here comes Dalton trying to fend off Matthew Francis and Mr. Tiddywink. It's going to be 3 over the line, almost head to tail. But Dalton will take Francis, who will take Mr. Tiddywink for P10. And J-Lo comes home in P11. Oh, some very close fighting there. Our first 3 races at Dragon Trail Gardens. But unsurprisingly, this man, Junior 2061, is the race winner. And as usual, we jump into the party chat just for a quick interview with these guys. And before we do, we'll have a quick look in our comment section as well and see what's been bubbling down there. I think Urban Fire has been active in there, an avid viewer of the series, an avid participant in our comment section. He said there, thanks to Chris for the hard work, and big thanks to the best comms guy in the business, Squid for Sky F1. Well, that's the highest compliment I think I've ever been paid. And if you'd like to watch comments just like that one in previous episodes on your Sky Q, what? No, not going to go there, never mind. But let's get into our party chat and see what the boys are up to. Good evening, everybody. You're live on ART TV. Please do not swear. Sorry for jumping so abruptly. I normally give you a message. That was a very bassy burp from somebody there. Let's have a chat first with Mr. Tillywink. You there, Mr. Tillywink?
Oh, me first?
Yes, you first.
Go on then, would you like to know?
Well, I'll say that you first is what I would have liked to have seen, apart from someone in the Mitsubishi Evo spoiling things as usual. But what happened to you in the hexagon? You seemed to suddenly take a right turn. You should have been going left.
To be honest, I just don't know this track. I know it the other way around.
I think we've all been there, safe to say.
That's one of the hardest turns, that hexagon turn.
It is very tricky to manage. It's all that balancing the throttle and maintaining as much momentum as you can. Yeah. It's not easy. But you definitely did make it easy on yourself there, and not making it easy on yourself if you want P3 in the championship, because Mad Adam, a pad finishing P3, has taken a huge haul of points off of you. What's your strategy going into round two?
No idea, because I've not planned one. Just race.
Well, let's hope that you can magic something out of the bag then for race two. Best luck to you there, Tilly Week.
By lap three, I'll be passing on the hexagon around the outside.
Well, let's see. Sergeant Phil's definitely got some faith in you then. I'll leave you guys to it then for race two. Have a good one then, guys. Sorry, I keep forgetting to ask them to mute themselves before I jump into the party chat. It's a very bad habit I've gotten into there. But yes, we'll see them take that race order for race two. So we'll see Quinny on pole, Nene in second. So hopefully we'll see Nene take the fight to him a little bit more. Mad Lad in P3, who I think maybe with one more good set of results could stick P2 permanently. And Chris Char will start P4, so a really good race from Chris Char. He's also progressed massively since the start of this series, so it's good to see him fighting for the podium spots as well. As has Disastrous Fate, with a really tough pick in the Scirocco, taking it really high up the grid there for P5. It's a great result from him. So hopefully we'll see him carry on a good vein of form in round two. But, as always, make sure you put in the comments who you'd like to see up on the top spot of the podium. Seven Grace Candles in the chat there. Good luck to all for the next race. Well, let's hope maybe a couple of other drivers get a good smell of the podium, as I'm sure we have some good smells coming from the Seven Grace Candles. So we should see round two kick off in just a moment. But yeah, Dragon Track Gardens, what a tricky track we've got for our finale here in the TCR Championship. Again, that hexagon's really thrown a couple of drivers for a loop. We saw Tiddy Wink and J-Lad find themselves the wrong way round once or twice there. A couple of other drivers getting very close to touching the grass on the outside, which of course is only going to send the cars into a spin. The light damage on for the TCR Championship fortunately means that the guys aren't having to dive into the pits each time things go pear-shaped, but of course it's the last thing they want to see happen to them when they are fighting for some crucial end of season points. And Sarah and Grace saying, great commentary throughout the 8 weeks. Thank you very much, Mr. Candles. I really appreciate that. It's very kind of you. I'm looking forward to some lovely illuminated scents being sent my way, courtesy of Chris R390. But enough about that though. We're getting on board for race two. We can see our first of our five red lights illuminated in the distance there. Got our five red lights and away we go. A much better start there from Jayla. Dalton noting for Bogdown has had disastrous fate there. Our front wheel drives, of course, notorious for poor launches. We'll jump on with Dalton though and see how he navigates turn one and two. Outbreaking Mr. Tillybink trying to swoop around the outside there of Jayla. And he has done so. Very clever indeed there from the orange Audi. Takes P9. So not the best of starts, but a good first double right-hander from Dalton. Sees him claim two places. We'll jump aboard there with Gina Quinn and see how the rest of the field handles the tricky hexagon here. Mad Lad washing out a little wide there, but aiming for a cutback instead. Oh, very tight to the apex there. These two are side by side heading up the hill. We jump further down the pack there. I think Sergeant Cohen found himself in the dust, and he's now eating the dust of disastrous fate up into P5. Matty Francis is maybe looking for a move on the outside there, but in fact, no, he's defending instead from Chris R390 and Dalton there with the menacing blue trim on the Audi there, almost day glow. He'll be sticking the mirror there as he sticks it down the inside of Chris R390, and now it's him up into P8. So Dalton going very aggressive. He can see on the soft tyres he's got to get up into the leading positions before those soft tyres start to give way. We have a look at the front though. Mad on the path has made his move on Gina Quinney and is now up into the lead of the race. However, this is where we're going to see if he's got something strategic to... Oh, as he goes all kind of sideways there. I was going to say, if he's got something strategic to think about in this race, or he's going to go flat out on the medium tyres, but they're definitely going flat out there over the dirt. Again, you know, the rally pedigree, the Evo coming in clutch there. Quinny in P2, Chris Chart up into P3, so already having one or two spots off of the grid already. As at Nene having lost a couple of spaces there from P2. Looking to try and pull one back, maybe. No, it's like the disastrous fate. They're trying to keep Chris Char at bay. Nene knows he has to go a little bit more carefully on his tyres here, but he's pushing that Lexus very hard out of turn two. You see, though, it's just not got the grind in a straight line compared to the Lexus, so he's going to make sure he sticks within the slipstream. But he hopes he'll pull him along away from Dalton, who's now up into P6. He's really pushing hard there. He's gone past Matthew Francis as well, we saw earlier. Now there's fighting going on just behind us here. Sergeant Cohen, Chris R390, door banging there. The BMW tries to hook it around the outside of the Mazda, forcing him to the inside of the corner. Very smart driving there from Chris. Gets his way around the Mazda. J-Lad there is trying to have a go at the axe action as well. He's going to gyre up the inside there of the Mazda. Oh, goodness me, it's huge shut inside of Chris R390. Buys off the wrong way around, and J-Lad has just driven off. That's not going to put him in anyone's good books. Let's see what's happened. Look there at Chris. So Ryan Ball with Chris R390. We can see Jay goes for a very bold move up the inside there. Oh, and it looks like there was a bump from Matthew Francis. If we jump back to that one again, let's have a look and see if that was indeed Matthew Francis that's caused this incident. So if we have a look from the front, I see, he's just not anticipated Jella breaking so early. He's breaking very late. Huge concertina into the hairpin, and that's caused Chris R390 to be facing the wrong way up a one-way street. Matthew Fuller doesn't have any favours either by going into the grass. Just about gets it on track before the barrier. Blimey. But that'll be one to review in the stewards room. One for sure, which I think will put Matthew Francis in the scene bin. Speaking of being in trouble, though, looks like disastrous fate is having a look for the lead of the race, and he is taking it from Mad Lad on the pad, who we saw had a huge resurgence there. Just trying to make some early gains, but disastrous fate decided that he wants to have the action as well, and he will take the lead. Gina Queen, though, still ever present in P3, as fate runs very wide off the track there, and he's got some dirty tyres to contend with as he heads through this tricky, handling middle sector. Already Madlad and Quinny making up for lost time as those dirty tyres on the Scirocco are not helping him out at all. Heading into the hairpin there, Quinny just threatening a move on the inside there of Madlad. Luke goes for a very, very late turn in, but I think that's only helped the man in the championship seat catch up to this battling pair at the front. Now Quinny's looking for a drag race up the back straight as they go to battle for the lead of the race eventually, but of course it's only going to allow Fate a little bit more leeway to pull away from them. Quinny makes his move up into P2, Maddox going very high off the sausage curb there, but keeps it in a straight line. Bounced off the inside of the apex as well, but he will have to settle for P3 for the time being. So look at Dalton, got a little bit of gap either side of him there, 1.3 seconds either way. We've got Chris Char down in P5, Nene in 6, and Nene having lost 4 places off the start of the race. He's short shifting though, so he's really trying to eke out what's left in this Mitsubishi for the next 4 minutes or so. Again, looks like he's going for that tried and tested 10 minutes for half a tank strategy we've seen many drivers employ over the past few seasons. We've got Mark Dalton here saying, let's go Dalton, cheering on his buddy in the chats there. Mainly looking for a driver with Chris Char. We know the Lexus is very punching straight line, but who's going to have the bigger cojones into the hexagon? Nene's going to try and hold around the outside, but Chris Char does have the racing line. They're still side by side though through 3 apexes, which is hugely commendable driving. Ah, oh, so unfortunate. Nene had the traction in the Evo, but just clipped the rear of that Lexus, and there's no move heading into the second sector here. It's very unfortunate, because what a great display of driving we saw there. Glad we caught that one on the stream. Just behind us though, the cars are really bunching up as well. Jay laid up in P7, Matthew Francis in P8, but of course I think he's going to be under investigation following the incident that caused Chris R390 to be sent to the back. Not quite a conventional line as well there from the Subaru driver that put Sergeant Cullen well off his stride there. Mr. Tiddywink, to what sound, he's been knocked off their stride. I think he may well be saying goodbye to P3 in the championship, because Nene had a much better run of things in the first race. Much better run of things in the second as well. And we might just see a very late switch up of point standings heading into the final standings here, as Sergeant Cullen runs very wide off into the gravel. What happened there? Let's have a quick look at that one. There's a bit of contact. Tiddywink seems to have let him go. I think, yes, there was definitely a bump there. You hear the rev spike in the Mazda there, and I think there we go, Tiddywink on the inside, just about giving him some leeway. But they're still fighting down the home straight. Of course, he gave him the corner back, but the straightaway was all to play for. Tiddywink has retaken P9, but gone very wide in the process. There might be another drag race heading down the second straight, but it looks like Tiddywink has that one in the bag, so no more battling from them. Battling instead though will be with these guys, Quinny and Disastrous Fate. Quinny and Mad Lad. Disastrous Fate has run away by 3 seconds, so he's really trying to put some distance between himself and these Mitsubishi Evos, which have been very competitive all season long. Quinny though is just keeping that a little bit smoother through the second sector there compared to Madlad, who's willing to throw the Evo through the corners. Again, Madlad on the pad, the clue's in the name. He's one of our few drivers still on the controller here. You can see the very aggressive inputs just by the on and off steering he's got going through his Evo, which probably contributes to the quite poor tyre wear he suffers during these races. But when he loses the entire life, he does make up for in outright pace and racecraft. He almost turns that Evo into a spacecraft, let alone racecraft. So these two in a world of their own here in P2 and 3. Dalton there in 4th, got 1.5 seconds away from Nene in P5, who has managed to get his way past Chris Char. Maybe an incident there that occurred off screen. Meanwhile, J-Leg in P2 has got Tiddywink 3 seconds down the road in P8, and he's still got Matthew Francis in the rear view, but maybe not for long as he slams into the barrier, diving into the pits there. I think probably a slightly unscheduled stop, but a good time to take it, I suppose, if you're going to lose time anyway. Matthew Francis takes P8. Chris R319 and Sergeant Colon are battling there for last position. And Chris concedes there to the man in the Mazda. Hopefully we'll see the BMW roar onto the back of it and maybe make another move on the inside. It looks like he's going to make that pass into the first of the 4 apexes here at the hexagon. He's gone very wide into the first one, but he's just about kept it on the black stuff for the rest of it, and actually comfortably see him onto the back of Matthew Francis in just a few moments. Battling is still going on ahead though. These guys are starting to close up on each other. Looks like Nene is now escaped from Chris Char. He's on the back of Owen Dalton, and we'll jump aboard there with Nene as he has a great exit there. And in fact, so it might even be a drag race to continue Henry, because that Evo looks like he's got to move down before they even head towards the chicane, and indeed he does, up into P4. However, Dalton is going to tuck into the slipstream briefly, just try and pick up a couple extra miles per hour, heading into the chicane. Now he's going to be outside, Dalton's going to be late on the brakes to the inside. Oh, there's some door banging going on there, but Nene is going to try and keep P4. He rides straight over the sausage curve there. Of course, not the ideal strategy in a low-slung car like a Formula 1 car, but he's got just enough clearance on them to make it viable, and Nene will keep P4. Disastrous fate then will dive into pits and off the soft tyres, 41% fuel. So he's going to have his one-stop contending for here. I think he will be putting himself out of contention compared to the leaders on the medium strategy. We see though a lot of other drivers pitting in at the 10 minute mark. Chris Jarre trying to defend there from J-Lad, who really catches up, having followed at a late apex there from Chris Jarre, but I don't think he's going to make a move into the hex. It'll be very bold to do so from this far away. Let's have a look as they head down into the braking zone, and Chris Jarre gained about a tenth in the slipstream, but he's not going to make a silly move into the braking zone. Chris R390 there, it's on a very worn set of soft tyres. I'm sure we'll have to see him jump in at the end of this lap to get some new boots, because they are not going to be comfortable at the end of the race if he keeps them on. And Crucian Sergeant Conan on the medium tyres with much more tyre life, I think should find a fairly easy overtake in his future. Chris defending the apex there, really blocking off the Mazda on the exit of the corner once. And the Mazda maybe was anticipating to be blocked there, moved to the inside, but Chris was already there. However, I think Chris now realises that his game is up, and he's going to let the Mazda just coast through there into P6. Oops, sorry, I've shot the control wheel. Tepper's Chris L390 down into 7th place. Disastrous fate, fresh out of the pits and a new set of soft tyres. Wow, the overspeed there on the BMW is huge. Moves past like he isn't even there. Takes P7, and I'm sure we'll see him take Sergeant Colon in a moment or two. We know Colon is having to save fuel. I think presumably going for a no-stopper, or maybe just a one-stopper if necessary. But you see he's run very wide. Again, Zoshred using the extra gear below there to get the Scirocco rotated through the corner, and he will take P6. Next in the queue is Chris Jarre, but he is 8 seconds up the road. He's going to have quite a task to try and catch him up. Again, he'll need about 2 seconds a lap to really reel him in. It is possible on soft tyres, but it will be close over the finish line. Over fire saying that Scirocco is like a rocket. I think we should be calling it the Scirocco instead, because it definitely moves like one. We'll do a quick recap, though, of our current standings. Gina Quinney leads Malad on the pad by 3 seconds. We saw Malad was going quite aggressive earlier, but Nasir's medium tyres really are starting to fall off the cliff. And we may well see him fall into the clutches of Nene. He's got slightly more tyre life left in his set of mediums here. And I think Madlad is now at an unfortunate point where he can't pit, so he will lose time to Nene. But if he doesn't pit, he's going to have some really horrible tyres by the end of the race. Jay has done very well so far in P4. He's got a pit stop coming up soon, as will Chris Jarre, I believe. Well, then again, he may not. No, Chris Jarre, I think, will be going to the end. So J-Lad might well be doing better to let Chris Jarre go here and not fight a fight that he will lose. So he gets all kinds of uncomfortable there over the sausage curve. We see Chris Jarre just lining him up, really, like a tiger stalking its prey. So he heads through the right hand here. J-Lad's going to try and defend it a little bit too late, I think, there, to be honest, J-Lad, as Chris Jarre moves up into the lead. Maybe J-Lad trying to secure the pit entry line there, but not the way to do it. You've got a car on your rearview mirror. J-Lad ducks into pits then, and it moves Disastrous Fate, who's been on an absolute tear here, and a 138.6. That's a really hot lap there from the Scirocco up in the P5. He has caught Chris Jarre by 4 seconds in the last couple of laps alone. So he may well be on for a chance at P4, and in fact, depending on Nene's pace, if he's only 6 seconds up the road, he could well be in for a chance of a podium spot. Of course, that's being very optimistic, but strange things have happened. So again, that's fate up into P5. Colon in P6, having relinquished the spot to the Scirocco. He's got 3.5 seconds over Chris R390 down in P7 on some incredibly warm soft tyres. I think Chris now just has to take him to the end, because if he pits at any point, he's going to lose a lot of time. just on the pit entry and exit alone. Dolan is going to be closing him down though on a fresh set of soft tyres in P8, as will Mr. Tinuin. He's got a fair amount of fuel to play with as well in P9. Matthew Francis there battling with J-Lad at the back of the pack, so it's good to see even at the back of the pack there can still be some fighting to be found. As Jarius, a late move the inside of Matthew Francis there, a little bit of door banging there. Francis keeps P10, but Jay might be better off not going for the move, going for the switch instead. And then maybe he's just about Herbie there, he's going to try and let Matthew take the lead. But Matthew Francis runs wide as Jay, very sideways there. He's lost all his momentum, and now Matthew Francis should have an easy run up to the chicane unmolested. See though where the battle's going on. I think it looks like Chris Char is now under threat from Disastrous Fate. He is indeed. Question is, where will Fate make his move? He's going to be holding on to the back of that bumper of the Lexus. Now he makes it up the inside, the soft tyres there gripping really intensely, and now it's a drag race down to the bottom of the straight. I think the Lexus might well have the legs, but we know that the Scirocco is going to be on him through the corners. Having said that, those soft tyres are really now starting to show prevalent wear. They're already about, say, 20% worn on the Scirocco. You can hear the scream in there, only making them worse. They may well be about level pegging by the time they come round to the end of the lap. But Disastrous Fate is not going to let this one go without a fight. You can see they're really throwing the Scirocco into the corners and trying to straighten up the exit down the hill here into the hairpin. Is there a lunge to be made here? No, he's going to be a bit early on the brakes instead, I think, and keep to the apex. Looks like Chris Char has run wide there. Scirocco will take the lead, but Chris Char with a straight line exit makes it a drag race down the back straight. The Lexus again just nipping in front of the Scirocco, but the Scirocco could afford to be a little bit late on the brakes there, depending on where Chris Char defends. He will move back onto the racing line. But the Scirocco is not going to make a late, desperate attempt here for P4. In fact, he's going to maybe throw his exit into one basket down the home straight one more time. Let's ride on board then with the Scirocco. And just lifting off there, coasting through the final corner. Lexus washing wide. But the Scirocco has moved up the inside line, and now he should have that move in the bag heading down main straight. They are side by side, but now the Scirocco can afford to move across and secure the racing line at the start of lap 11. Some really well thought out driving there by Disastrous Fate. He takes P4. Jump to the front of the pack though with Gin and Quinny. He has gotten 6 seconds away from Nene. So again, this really is his race to lose. But Nene is now also under threat from the Mad Lad on a pad. We run aboard with Nene and see what he's got going on behind. We can see Malay is only half a second behind and gaining. Okay, if we have a quick double check, we can assume they're Mad Lad's tyres. They are indeed worse for wear than Nene. So as long as Nene just keeps it calm and collected, he'll be forcing Mad Lad to push even harder on a really abused set of medium tyres. I don't think that's what he wants to do, because he's very late on the brakes there. But you can see the angle of the turning from the shot from the Evo just isn't able to match what Mad Lad wants it to do in the corners. And of course, all that extra scrubbing on the tyres is not going to be doing him any favours. You can just see as well at the very back of the hill there, Disastrous Fate and Chris Char on the very periphery of the shot here. So they may well give these guys something to think about as they head around for one more lap, I think is what they're going to be doing here. So I think Nene should be quite comfortable heading through the final corner. We will have a look though, just to see if Mather has got something to fight with. But you can see the Evo is already washing out very wide, costing him time on the exit, and now you see he's just losing time hand over fist down the home straight. He's gaining a tiny bit back now in the slipstream, but what was about 5 tenths there is now almost 7 as they head into the braking zone of turn 1 for what I believe will be the last time. Disastrous Fate has quite a healthy gap now over Chris Char in P5. Looking back down the pack, Sonic Fennel in P6 should be very comfortable. Tinuin is up into P7, though Dolan is trying to hunt him down in P8. His soft tyres though are looking very worn, so he's going to have to make sure he has a good exit here if he wants a chance at having the BMW down the straightaway. You see that Dolan using second gear, trying to get all the power and torque out of the Audi, but the traction control nipping out in the bud. It's not helped him on the exit there really. He's out of the slipstream, so he's going to have a really good middle sector if he wants to have another go for P7. Built Chris R390 down in P9 following that incident at the start of the race. Jalen in P12 and Matthew Francis at the instigator of said incident in P11.
But still fighting to the very end of the race.
Something we love to see here at Amigos Racing Team, and if you do want to get involved in our plethora of events, our Discord link is in the description below, so please check that out and get involved in one of the incredible race formats we've got on offer here on Gran Turismo Sport and Gran Turismo 7. We've also got Assetto Corsa Competizione and Formula 1 seasons ongoing as well. As Matthew Francis, defending very aggressively there, will jump and cut away very quickly as Ginny Quinney takes race two. But these two are still really battling for the final spot on the grid. It looks like Nene and Mad Lad are going to be heading over the grid side by side there for P2 and 3 respectively. Another crucial points haul for Nene over Mr. Tinnywig. Disastrous fate, a fantastic result for him, will take P4. Chris Char is just about out of fuel. It's going to be very close. It looks like Sergeant Colonel might even take him on the line. Goodness me, he will indeed. Colonel in fifth, Chris in sixth, Mr. Tinnywig in seventh, Dalton in eighth, Chris R390 on his own there in P9. J-Lad is just about holding up Matthew Francis there in P10. He's definitely got the fuel to finish, but look at that, a fight to the very end. You love to see it, but you've got a feel there for Chris Char. They're just running out of fuel on the line. Absolutely horrible luck. But second race of two tonight goes to the omnipotent, ever-dominant Ginny Quinney 61. Let's make sure I actually get these guys to mute this time. Who are we going to have a chat with today? Let's have a chat with Sergeant Colon. Colon and Nene, I think we're going to have a chat with today. So let's get our results screen back up for the second to last time. And as always, let's get those post-race interviews in. Good evening, guys. You're live on ART TV. Please keep it clean. Or keep it clean, I should say. That one was that right. Nene, you there, Nene?
Yes, pal, I'm here.
I'd say that's another huge points haul for you there compared to Mr. Tinnywig down in P7. I haven't done the maths yet, but as far as I'm aware, you are well within a shot of taking P3 off of him for the final standings. What's your view going into the final race?
Yeah, possibly. I'm more of the same. Just sort of keep hold of the tyres, don't use too much fuel, and try and stay in front of the people who are pitting.
Sounds like you've got this one all worked out then. Best of luck to you then for the final round. And Sergeant Colon, are you there?
I am indeed.
Well, that was a close one on the line, wasn't it?
You ran out of fuel.
I saw we just about ran out, I think, as he was heading up towards the pit lane. And you two were going very, very gristly for quite a chunk of that race. So how's it feel seeing him as he crossed the line and was giving him the Paul Walker drive-by?
You should hear the cheer I do. My wife almost came in to see what was going on. Yeah, so I've enjoyed both races, actually. Battling in the middle is good fun.
Well, of course, we've seen some fantastic battles in this race from the front, middle and the back, so let's hope you're in a couple more of those heading into the final event. Best luck to everybody then for the final round of the TCR, and we'll see you guys at the end.
Cheers.
Oh, yeah, my heart does go out to Chris Char. He's done so well over the past few races. So to then see himself run out of fuel on the line is heart-wrenching. But let's make sure that we tell you guys that we're all good to go. I think we've just seen all of our drivers just about getting onto the grid for the final round. Let's check back in the comments one more time. Urban Fire saying, great racing, guys, and three fire emoji in the comments there. And again, this is the beauty of Amigos. Whether it's the front, middle, or the back, there seems to be some really hard but fair racing going on at every point in the grid. So again, please get involved. Drop a like on the video if you haven't done one already. Please consider subscribing to the channel. It helps us grow, helps us put out more content, shows us that you enjoy what you're watching, that you're somewhat appreciating my evening ramblings and more importantly the incredible racing content that we're providing you. And maybe let's just see if someone other than Gina Quinn finds himself on the top step of the podium tonight. It's not asking much. But let's get some variety in tonight's racing, eh? As always, we're going to jump on board at the back with our championship winner, Gina Quinn, and get his perspective on things as they are about to get the green light. That's our fifth and final red light of the TCR, and we're underway. Again, another disappointing start there, but looks like no need to give disastrous fate a bit of a bump there, a bit more impetus off the start line. Let's see, we've got there, who is that man? He's a Sovcon hugging that interline very tight. There's a spinner in the middle, it's Chris Char. So Nene takes avoiding action there, and just trying to rejoin there, not much space to play with. But I'll save the highlight of that, and we'll jump back to that one later if we can. It stands, we've got Dalton and Tilly going side by side. Dalton late on the brakes there. Tilly Vink will let him go through. Sees Dalton up into P5. Tilly looking at the inside though as a cutback through the hexagon. He's been forced to the inside there by Dalton and he's been brushed wide as a result. Not really sure what could be done there. I think Dalton could get a little bit more space in the inside for Tilly Vink. Tilly also gets a bit of space as well. Gets a bump up the rear from Chris Char as well for good measure. But it's a very hectic start we've seen here already as the someone moving it out of the way there, I think. I think Tilly Vink, there we go, maybe letting Dalton keep his position as there's another roll move up the inside there from Nene. He doesn't want to be behind Gina Quinn, he wants to get out of the way. These guys are still fighting side by side, tooth and nail here for what is ultimately P6. They're going to ride on board them with Dalton as he's got these guys in his rearview mirror. He's got Chris Charles to the inside, he's going to have to let him go. He's now on the inside line. Gina Quinney's trying to make sure he doesn't push Dalton too far, but he is going to nudge him through the corner, which I'm sure Dalton will be very thankful for. Chris Charles on the inside of Quinney, but he might have a cutback. Dalton goes over the sausage curve and loses it entirely. Oh, he's just pushed Colin onto the inside of the track, but fortunately no damage to him. No damage to Colin either, but goodness me, that was a crazy start to proceedings, wasn't it? And it's still kicking off. And this is only for P6, guys. Got to throw a like on the video for that already. Look at this amazing race we're going on. It's only for the midfield. Chris Char going for a late lunge at the inside there of Tilly Vink, but nothing happening there. However, they have been compromised through that corner. Chris Char getting a little bit sideways on the way out. If we can, let's have a quick look if we can at what happened at the start of that race with Chris Char. As far as I can tell, that he got put into a half spin there. Looks like Tilly Vink did leave him the space, and maybe he got a bit of a push there. And just about kept it on the inside. He's been drifting in second gear. Colon clips the barrier there as well. Fortunately, no damage, but that's the last thing everyone wanted to see. What we are enjoying to see, though, is this man here, Matthew Francis, keeping his head clean of all of that, out of all of that disastrous start there, and in the lead. But again, very late on the brakes, a bit later than I think he would have liked to have been. Now it's Christophe Rinanti up the inside. And again, I'm sure they see that BMW find his way past the Subaru here. BMW is an absolute weapon down the straight, and there he goes. Just a touch of slipstream is all he needs. Matthew Francis taking the wider line. Chris trying to avoid the sausage curb. He avoids the first one. Matthew Francis being a much braver line there through the second corner, and to his credit, will keep the lead. A very bold attempt there from Matthew Francis. It does pay off for him, but he's not quite made the apex of this right-hander. He's going to have to lift up on the exit there, and this allows Christophe Rinanti to maintain more momentum. That's going to be well and truly in the slipstream there. Matthew Francis holds to the outside line. Christophe Rinanti takes to the inside and has first place before the braking zone. As you can comfortably see him up into P1. Disastrous fate as well. Look at the inside there for P2, and that's a double pass. And in fact, Madad on the pad, I think he's going to try to get a piece of cake here, a piece of the action here as well. Let's see if it is a piece of cake though for the Evo driver. He's not going to have a chance into the hexagon, at least not his way in. But again, you see him holding that wider line, looking for that cutback, waiting for the door to open, and he can jump through. Nothing happened though. Good driving now from Matthew Francis. I think maybe he's not for his mistake at the previous two rounds, but you see a compromised entry there. Maybe he could have kept wide there, used a wider line, and maybe straightened up the entry. That's allowing Madad to slowly pick his way back onto the back of the Subaru here. And Matthew Francis is defending, I think, known in the trade, defending thin air. But parking it on the exit of the corner there. just stopping Mad Lad from making his way past the Subaru. But Matthew asks if he's defending now, what he's defending, if he's defending at all, because he's just ruining his corner entrance for no reason here. A much better attempt there from Matthew Francis, knowing that Madlad is well and truly in his rearview mirror. Really, Matthew Francis needs to try and keep his disastrous fate at arm's length. Because once he loses that slipstream, which I think he has indeed lost the slipstream. Sophie's cheering him on and saying, you've got this, but he might not have him much longer. So he was trying to keep in the slipstream of the Scirocco, but he's lost it now. Madlad is now side by side, heading down the straightaway. And it looks like Mallard will have the inside line and he will take P3. Chris Shaw there after his incident at the start of the race in P5. We may well see our first set of pit stops coming in the next lap or two. Gina Quinney on the soft tyres there, pushing it as hard as he can. They're using up all the fuel on the soft tyre while he can, down in P6. We've got Mr. Tillywig up in 7th place, J-Led in 8th with Sergeant Cullen hot on his heels in 9th place. Let's run on board then with J-Lad to see what a Apollon is going to do. Maybe Sergeant Cullen is going to try and put a full stop to J-Lad's dominance on P8. No, it was a bump up the hill instead. As J-Lad runs very wide there on the exit tree at the corner. Runs even wider on the exit, and Sergeant Cullen nips up the inside and will take P9 or P8 for him. So not the best driving there from J-Lad, unfortunately. Now he's got Nene threatening to take P9 from him as well. He's just about holding him on the outside of the corner there. Good driving there from J-Lad, but Nene with the four-wheel drive traction off the exit will be out of there like a scalded rat. He just can't get the legs of the BMW. So we'll see here if there's anything to be made on the entry to the chicane. No, Nene's going to keep it wide, keep it clean. J-Lad launching over the sausage curve there. Not the first one, unfortunately. Now he's going to have to clip this apex nice and tight. He's not quite made the apex though, but he has kept the outside of the corner away from the clutches of Nene. And kept a very nice tight apex there as well through the final corner. He will duck into the pits though, so that fight ultimately for nothing it seems. But Madlad on the path though, has found his way past disastrous fate. And is now pushing like mad for the lead of the race. You see though, Gina Quinney's trying to get away around Disastrous Fate. Quinney also pushing ultra hard on the soft tyres. He is indeed ahead of Disastrous Fate, heading into the braking zone. Let's run on board then with Fate. So Quinney went very wide through that second apex. Fate just about had a sniff at recovering P2, but now I think he's going to see Quinney drive off into this very idyllic sunset here at Dragon Trail in Croatia, as we said. You see, the Scirocco just hasn't got the grip anymore to keep up with the Evo through this tricky sector of the track. Mr. Tillywink, trying to make amends for his previous two races, is up in P4, but he's running quite low on fuel now, so we'll see him dive into the pits fairly soon. Colon, though, hot on his heels in P5. Very late on the brakes there, into the hairpin. And go for that four-wheel drive, straight line, slingshot exit there, out of the final corner. Try and see him catch up onto the rear of the BMW, but it's just not happening for the time being. However, he's looking for a cutback on the exit of the chicane. It's very bold indeed, just skimming the gravel as well. And I think there we'll see Tillywink dive into the pit as Sergeant Cullen makes his way around for one more lap. Perhaps trying to threaten a mistake out of Tillywink there. Is that Cullen will actually dive into the pits with him? No, he's going to maybe just try the last dregs of slipstream there before heading back on the track. Very risky there. I've seen many drivers end up the nose first in the pit wall. The Colonel will keep P3 then. Nene up into P4. Chris Arthur in 90 is made an earlier pit stop here. Let's see where he emerges regarding everybody else. See, no one's counting the pits yet in front of him. See, Ginny Quinney is just emerging behind him there, as is Chris Charles. He's coming, well, Chris Charles coming out in P7. Quinney has left the pits already. Matthew Francis is just lurking in the back of the shot there in the pit lane. He's that's very close, and he's just going to cut around the outside of Mr. Tillywig there for P8. Let's get another look at that one quickly. So run on the front move, Matthew Francis instead. There he is. There comes Mr. Tillywig out the pit lane, that the awareness of both drivers just to make sure there's no contact at the apex. Fantastic work from Perry. Mr. Tillyman though is hot on the heels there of Matthew Francis. We see the soft tyres as BMW being put to work. He's got Chris Child just heading over the crest of the hill as well. That's very reassuring to know he's got someone at his pace not too far away. Matthew Francis defending very aggressively there from Mr. Tillywink. Tillywink looking for the cutback, just feathering the throttle here. You can see the BMW is that much more agile here on those softer, newer tyres, it seems. And there goes the lunge into the hairpin. He has got the inside line. Has he got the traction on the exit? Though there's another bit of a paint trading there, but no, he's going to tuck back into the slipstream. Maybe make a move heading towards the chicane. Let's jump back on board then. You can see he's all over the back of that Subaru. Less than a tenth in it now. Now he pulls to the inside line. Is the move made? No, they're side by side through the chicane. Matthew Francis holds him off for one more sector. Great defensive driving here from the Subaru. Tillywick though, looking for another cutback, and there he goes to the inside now. Maybe that's Matthew Francis having to give that one up for the slipstream. No, he's going to hug it around the outside instead. We've seen both drivers though using the grass, and it's going to be a straight line drag race over the finish line. But Mr. Tillywick has this one sewn up. But Matthew Francis will be in the slipstream though. This is going to be very close heading into the first corner. Matthew Francis ducks out of the slipstream. He's slightly later on the brakes. Mr. Tillywick tries to cut the nose off, but has to move back out of the apex. Goodness me, they are still side by side, but now Tillywink has that one in the bag, I think. You see, he's just about gaining there, about a quarter second ahead there of Matthew Francis. There's no diatom to be made there. Matthew Francis gives that one up and will resign himself to P7. Colon is in 8th, Nene is in 9th, Dalton is in 10th, J-Lad is currently at the back of the pack. Look in the midfield though, maybe jumps about P5. We can see here Chris Char is just trying to reel in Disastrous Fate. He's 1.8 seconds away though. A nice fresh set of soft tyres though should help him do so. You can just see him heading around the hairpin there. So Disastrous Fate has had the better of Chris Char heading out of the hairpin, also on a fresh set of soft tyres, but also about a quarter tank less fuel though. So using a nice light Scirocco to his advantage there. The run aboard there with him, you see Madame Pack getting very ragged there through the chicane as Josh Freight again just about lift out the throttle there on the exit of the chicane. That was the he'd be risking understeering fairly wide there into the gravel. We've seen drivers him up there, and that's definitely not a fun place to be. We do know, however, Josh Freight definitely has the pace in the Scirocco. We saw him set a blistering lap in the previous race. Urban Fire commenting that it is indeed a rocket. Let's see if he has got the jet fuel behind him here in P4. The drivers now seem to be settling into a rhythm. We have the reverse grid. We have most drivers now make their pit stops. So we can see our current race leader, Chris R390, on a 31 set of soft tyres, not going so comfortably through the hexagon. They're missing the third apex. There's now got Gina Quinney hot on his heels. We're riding aboard then with our current reigning champion here as he heads through the second sector. Chris running fairly wide there as he heads up that uphill right hand. It's always a tricky corner there because you can't quite see the apex or the exit of the corner. But Quinney definitely knows where it is, and he's hot on the heels of the BMW. And Chris trying to usher the Mitsubishi into the lead so he can slipstream past him. A very smart tactic, but of course Quinney has got the fresh set of soft tyres, so he'll have a huge slingshot out of the hairpin. Quinney now is going to try and... He wasn't going to defend, but now he's moved to the outside of the racing line. It's like Chris has let that slipstream move actually work against him now, with Quinney in the lead on a soft set of tyres, which have almost nowhere to them at all. And Quinney's now going to pull away. He has indeed already put up the slipstream with just three corners after having made the overtake. Chris R390 on his soft tyres, that early stop is not working to his benefit here. And in fact, you've got Madden on the pads catching him now, also on a fresh set of soft tyres in P3. So Chris may well be falling prey to both of these Mitsubishis before midpoint of our race has come. We are almost at the middle of our race there, 16 minutes remaining plus one lap. Gina Quinney has just taken the lead from Chris R390. Madden on the pad is in P3. Disastrous Fate is in 4th, Chris Char in 5th, Mr. Tillywick climb around the first corner in 6th, he's got Matthew Francis for company in P7, Sergeant Kelman is in 8th with Nene down in P9, so not the best race for Nene here. Owen Dalton is in P10. And we have J-Lab rounding out the pack here in P11. Not the best event for J-Lab. Poor guy. He jumped back to P3 though. We saw Mavos trying to make some gains there on Chris R390. And he has already taken a second out of him in the first sector alone. Kamau's going to go up the inside here of Chris into the hairpin. Very late on the brakes. Going to hug it super, super tight. And he will slingshot out of that corner into P2. Chris R390 though had a fairly good exit himself. And will be in the slipstream of that Evo. But I'm not too sure it's worth him making a move here. Into the chicane because his tyres are fairly worse for wear, and indeed he has to brake just about the same time as the Evo to avoid hitting the back of it. You see there, Mad Lad shutting the door on him in the chicane there, and that's forced Chris Island to take a compromised line. He's now lost a heap load of time there to Mad Lad on a pad, and even more to Disastrous Fate, who is lurking behind there in the Scirocco. So that early stop for Chris, maybe trying to get out of the traffic, in fact put him into a world of trouble. And now Disastrous Fate well in the slipstream there, 38.7, nothing compared to the 37.6 we've seen from Chicken Quick. That is astonishing, that, I must be said. But Disastrous Fate will hopefully be the next one to put the nail in the coffin of Chris R390. Have a look on board with him as he heads into the hexagon. I think we just saw his continuing dive into the pits there as well. You see there, really, Fate is much more aggressive for that first apex. Not quite clipping the second one or the third one, but he's going to try and straighten off the final one as much as he can. A little bit too much there, heading onto the grass, but still keeps some momentum over the course of R390. A little bit of a lift, though, just to make way for BMW on the apex. Chris running very wide. Disastrous Fate is going to try and spur that one off. Again, a huge slingshot out of that corner, but he just can't place the car on the right point on the track to make the most of it. Let's see that as Chris R90 tries to take a tight line here. And so you're getting a bit sideways there, a bit of the back stepping out there. Disastrous Fate had a bit of understeer instead. Both of them are balancing out here as they head down the back straight of the track. This is really not working very well for the pair of them, but the Scirocco now in the slipstream takes another 0.2 there out of Chris R390 as they head into the chicane. The Scirocco much tighter to the apexes here than the BMW. And in fact, you might well see him nip up the inside of the final corner. If you've seen him do it before, it's a favoured move for Disastrous Fate. He's going for it again. Chris has been pushed wide to the outside of the track, and he will give back P3 as I believe he peels off into the pits there, if he does indeed. So Disastrous Fate wasn't made easy for him, but now finds himself up onto the final step of the podium, at least for the time being. Chris Child will jump up into P4. Chris Knight in the pit there with his tyre change. He's now going to put some fuel in the car. He's going to need a fair amount of fuel there, and those soft tyres are not going to be fun to drive on by the end of the race with the amount of fuel that he's going to put in. He's already down in P8 here in the pits. And make that P9 as Dalton makes his way past him in the pits. He'll just about have him by turn one, I think. Yes, he will. But that should be enough to see Chris go to the end of the race on this set of tyres and fuel. Sorry, I do apologise. I've got something in my eye. Right, let's see where we are now then. Sorry, I can actually see. Looks like there is a little bit of a battle going on just up the road. If you look where Nene is, no, it might be Sergeant Francis and Matthew Colon then. Oh, sorry, I should say Matthew Francis and Sergeant Colon, I apologise. And it was indeed Matthew Francis. They may have just lost that place there to Sergeant Colon. You can see his front tyres are definitely looking worse for wear there. They are not comfortable at all. And again, he's gone very late into that braking zone to the very extremity of the track there. And I think this will allow Nene to have a convincing run at him along the back straight. He's already taken out a tenth and a half, make that 0.2. You see the Evo there trying to reel in the Subaru. That's 0.3 now as he heads into the chicane there. Matthew Francis had a very good line through the chicane though. He's definitely getting better at that with the more times he takes it. But unfortunately, Nene, I think, just has slightly grippier tyres underneath him and may well find himself at P6 by the time they get to the top of the straight. Let's have a look on board then. But with Nene, he runs very wide. Matthew Francis is in fact going to peel off into the pit lane. So Nene will resume P6 by default. Just behind us though down the track, Dalton and Chris R390 getting into it here. let's have a little ball with Dalton, as he's got that black and orange BMW looming in his mirrors. Two black and orange machines here making their way onto lap 12 here at Dragon Trail Gardens. Dalton will keep P7 into turn 1. Chris Arvinati getting very close there, I think, to turn 2. Dalton hitting the rev limiter at the top of second gear there. That's now Chris to catch up a little bit further, but he cannot make his way past the Audi for the time being. Now, have a look at the inside, though, into the hexagon. He's not quite got that move, but he did scare Dalton running a little bit wide. And now, with a compromised line, Chris is going to cut on the inside there. He's not quite gone on the through the whole curb there, maybe a bit of grass as well. But he will take P7 away from the Audi TT. It's gone quite wide there as a consequence. It looks like maybe Dalton might well have a look at the outside of him again, but it seems to be that they are maybe just throwing away time in different places, and ultimately I think this will be Chris R390's P7 for kicks. Gina Quinney dives into the pits there, as does Mad Lad. Christian Mad Lad with another 10% more fuel than Gina Quinney. They were very close when they entered the pit lane, so they could be even closer by the time they come out. However, we know that Mad Lad has saved in fuel, he can't quite save in tyres. That could well be his undoing. Let's run on board there with Mad Lad as he's getting the fuel put into that Evo. That's the sound of Quinny leaving the pit lane. Mad Lad is not far behind. Sergeant Collins just about jumping them. As we see, he leapfrogs Gina Quinny. Nene also leapfrogs Mad Lad into P4. I think Mallet is going to have to make his way past Nene as quickly as he can. We jump all with Gina Quinny. He is into the pit of Sergeant Cullen. Cullen's going to try and defend this one into the hexagon. Then moves back onto the racing line. Quinny has to lift. As Cullen will keep P2. He's going to try and keep Quinny honest there through the quadruple left-hander. Looks like Quinny's happy just to sit back for the time being. Quinny doesn't have to fight for anything. He's got the championship sewn up. There's no need for any dangerous or aggressive or desperate moves. But I think he wants to keep Mad Lad as far away as possible, who's already ahead of Nene. He has made that move early. I think Quinny's seen that, and then now he wants to get away from the Mad Lad on the pad. He's seen him in the mirrors. Quinny dives to the inside of Sergeant Colon, and he takes P2. Colon, though, is going to have the slipstream back on Gina Quinny. And maybe they're talking in the party chat now, and he's going to get a bump draft. He's going to make the move. But either way, Mad Lad is a Mad Lad on a mission to try and get the net lead of this race. We know Chris Char up ahead, 16 seconds up the road. It still has a pit stop to make, as far as I'm aware. Let me quickly check on with him. Yes, he's diving for pits now, in fact. So we can see Quinny is ahead of Sergeant Colon, but Colon's gone very wide there into the gravel. Mad Lad on the pad is now past him. And now it's really a battle of these two Evos here to see who is going to take the win. We know Mad Lad is going to go absolute balls to the wall here in pursuit of the championship winner. So Mad Lad, having missed a few events in the series, will probably be quite gutting, knowing that he may well have had his hands on the trophy himself if he had attended all the races. But now I think it's his chance to show his true pace and see he can take the fight to Gina Quinny. We know Gina Quinny's had the fastest lap there, 37.6. Mad Lad might well have something to say about that on this lap while the tyres are still fresh and fruity. In fact, let's ride on board with Mad Lad and see how much time he can take out of Gina Quinny. Nothing out of the hexagon, though. He's already lost about a tenth or two to him there. But can he make any gains here? Just driving flat out as aggressive as possible. Let's see. But he has gone into the grass there a little bit, but he's keeping it clean now, more importantly. He's gained about 2 tenths back there, having been on the grass. But I think Mallard's just pushing a little too hard now. He's going to be regretting that later if the tyres don't last. Quinny there being more conservative. He's only lost about another half a tenth through that corner alone, but I'm sure that will come back to him later in the race with the nicer tyres. He jumps to the back of the pack. I can see him fighting going on through the hexagon, I think. Oh no, it's maybe just a very thick arrow there from obviously Dalton. Never mind. They have got some fighting here though. Look at Chris Char, in fact, with Chris R390 heading into the chicane. We know Chris pitted in one lap before Chris Char. So these two are on more or less the same strategy. If you look at tyres and fuel, Chris Char has much better looking tyres and a touch more fuel, so you might want to see Chris Char use that to his potential here, as he hugs that inside apex of the long right-hander. Chris, I can have taken a slightly nicer line, but the slipstream could prove to be the effective weapon here. Chris, after notes can defend to the inside nice and early. Slight move back towards the racing line there, but Chris Charm maybe looking for an undercut here on the inside line. It's just not going to work out there. Being very considerate of each other, though, that's what we love to see here at Amigos. At the front of the pack, though, it seems that Mad Lad on the pad is not gaining any time there on Junior Quinny. In fact, he's lost another half second since we checked in on them. So really, I think Quinny, the consistency is going to be key here for him. Soldier Curler in P3, having a fairly good race by his thumbs as well. He's got 5 minutes left, though, on those soft tyres. They are not going to be fun after another couple of laps, but he's doing very well to keep it in third place. Manny behind him, though, on a nicer set of mediums, could well be in with a shot of that final podium place. And again, that might not be in third place in this race, but could well be third place in the series, following Tiddy Winks' escapades into the gravel earlier tonight. But we will jump on board, though, with Noni. He really is reeling in Sergeant Coleman there, just about touching the slipstream as he heads through the chicane here, using the ground cruiser of the Evo to head over the sausage curve rather than across it. And that's gave him another half a second into the final corner. But I think he's just been thrown off by the dirty air in that Mazda. And he's going to lose some more of that time as they head on to the start finish straight. And it's about 2.5 tenths there back down the drain from Noni. He's still got 4 minutes under his belt. That's probably another 3 laps, I'd say, there that he's got to play with, as Colin runs very wide indeed. Might not need 3 laps, he might get it done within the next half a lap. Colin runs again wide into the exit of turn two. Nene's only a quarter second behind him now. Is there a lunge to be made into the hexagon? He's not going for it here, it looks like. No, but maybe now he knows with some dirty tyres, Curlon may be prone to another mistake or prone to understeering wide here. He's really trying to keep that Mazda glued to the track, but it's not wanting to go where he points it. Having said that, though, Nene erring on the side of caution has now lost the slipstream to Sergeant Curlon. So you have to try and get that one back as quick as he can. Otherwise, he may be ruined the fact he didn't pounce on his mistake earlier. And crucially as well, Disastrous Fate is now trying to reel this pair in as well. So this could be a three-way fight for the final spot on the podium. Chris Child down in P6 there, having gotten past Chris Offrey 19th with P7. Tiny down in P8, and Matthew Francis is in 9th. Owen Dalton kind of on his own there in 10th place, as is J-Lad in P11. Tina Quinny, though, we see has run away with this one yet again, going even faster in the last 2 laps there, 137.377. Almost equaling it there, 137.6. It really is putting his foot down now on these soft tyres. A Mad Lad, 37.9 his best. We just cannot compete with Gina Quinney. Curlin is in P3, but maybe not for long, as Nane's with the inside line. Curlin will move back onto the racing line. Nane's very late on the brakes there. He's going to park it right in front of the Mazda, which he does. Very smart driving from Nene. A bold move, but he makes it stick into P3. However, Sergeant Coleman has had a great run off the exit of turn two there, and might well fancy his chances into the hexagon here. He's well alongside Nene, and into the braking zone. He's going to outbrake him very late and very brave. That's going to be P3 for Sergeant Coleman. And Nene now having to look a front and behind him there, as Disastrous Fate now wants a slice of the action. Let's jump aboard then with the Scirocco. Nene gets a half second penalty for exceeding track limits there in the hexagon. And now this will be good news for Disastrous Fate. Now at some point Nene is either going to make a mistake or have to give up half seconds worth of time to him. But let's see how the Scirocco handles the back straight here. A great exit there. I mean, a little bit of a bump there on Nene's, not what he was looking for, but a double slipstream for him might well secure his move up into the chicane. Let's see how he does here. 2.5 tenths back, make that 2 tenths, and that 1.5 tenths, but there's no move to be made there. Nene is still using the slipstream of Colon to just pull away that little bit extra that he can. However, Dostrate has a fantastic run out of the chicane. Nene perhaps being hindered there by Sergeant Colon, and again, Disastrous Fate using that trademark inside line there on the final corner takes P4 off of Nainer, who runs into the gravel once again. Chris Char is now on the back of this trio here, making it into a quartet. And in fact, his chance is on Nene into the first corner, going for the inside line, just trying to threaten him in his mirrors, but there's no move there. However, the inside of turn two has a fantastic run. Nene will try and force him away from the slipstream. A disastrous fate is now looking through behind Sergeant Pearl. They are 2x2 heading into the hexagon here, and disastrous fate makes a move up the inside, holding the brakes there through the second apex, makes it stick, and he's up into P3. Colonel is into fourth. We've got Chris Char now past Nene for, or still past Nene for P5. Look at the inside of Sergeant Colonel. There could be a real fight on our hands here for P3. It could go any way of four, as we've still got half a lap to play with. This is going to be their final lap here. So I think Quinny and Mallard have finally settled this one. Sergeant Cohen going from the inside there, but Chris Charles on his inside as well. He had to stop an absolute standstill. And Nene, they go three wide here. He's going to take two places. Fantastic move there from Nene. He's going to take two places there. Caught them both napping on the apex. They're trying to avoid stumbling over each other. However, Nene has got Cohen and Chris Char hot on his heels. He's going to sit in the middle of the track. Chris Char has looked at the inside there at the chicane. Oh, he's sliding Lexa through, but he's got the move made. Oh, this is going to be hectic. Disastrous fate is going to be licking his lips here. If he can save the fuel for the final corner, Ginny Quinney takes the win. Mallard in P2, but I could not cut away from this. It's going to go any set away over the line. Nene, he's going onto the grass. No, he's going to throw away P5 to Sergeant Colon. There's a bit of door banging there. Maybe some friendly door banging. It looks like Sergeant Colon has that one in the bag. Nene in P6. Goodness me, what a finish that was. Not just to a race, but to a series. Mr. Tiddywick takes P7. Chris R390, the curator of the series, will come home in P8. Matthew Francis will come home in P9. And already over the line, one lap down, are Dalton and J-Lad. But goodness me, what an event that was at the end there. Blimey. So for the final time this series, our race winner, our series winner, Ginny Quinney, 61, comes home first. And we jump into our results screen. We'll get our final set of race interviews with everyone. Why not? Let's check in on everybody. Good evening, guys. Yeah. You're live on ART TV. Please keep it clean for the final time this series. I won't ask you any more, I promise. But wow, what a finish that was. I mean, I couldn't cut to Quinny and Madler crossing the line because that was a given formality anyway, I think. But firstly, disastrous fate. Are you there?
Yep.
I'm hoping your audio is being shared. I'm not sure if it was last time, but you must be very happy with P3.
Oh, you should have heard it at the party. I was nearly screaming. Yeah, I am happy. Because at least towards the end of the season, because I already got 2 podiums, but they just weren't streamed. So, you know what I mean? I got this one here on the very last race, so I'm pretty happy with that.
Well, I say, you've driven the absolute wheels off that Scirocco. You really had the duff pick of cars there, but you've done extremely well with that. You should be very proud of a podium finish.
Appreciate it. Thank you very much. And yeah, I was like everybody in the chat was saying as well, like, just boasting, well, really. Like, flat out give everything.
Oh, absolutely, we've done a fantastic job. Well done there on your podium. Is Thank Chris you. Char there as well?
Yes, and I've shared my audio this time as well.
Oh, fantastic. Good to hear you in the party then, good to hear you in the interviews then. But that was a very close battle there at the end, wasn't it, with Sergeant Colin and Nene. What's going through your mind then? Because at one point you were P6, I think.
Yeah, it was just brilliant. Last race racing, really, to be fair.
So and what happened at the hairpin? Because it looked like you maybe Colon stumbled over each other, and then Nene went up the inside of the pair of you, but couldn't keep it.
Yeah, well, I think Sarge were trying to like attack back at Disastrous, didn't know I were there, and then like cut across, and then Nene saw opportunity, and then obviously Lexus, so I'm a bit quicker out of the corner, so I might get run on them then. But it was brilliant. That was good fun.
Well, that was a cracking set of races then. Really testament to the fact that everyone in the lobby here has improved tremendously. in stepping up progressively. So I doff my hat to all of you. It's been fantastic to see you guys develop. And I'm hoping to see some of you guys maybe racing with me or racing with some of our more experienced drivers up in the ART Championship. And I think final thoughts really ought to go to Chris R390. If you're there, Chris.
Yes, I'm here.
I just want to say firstly, thank you so much for putting on such a tremendous... successful and entertaining series for myself, for the guys watching at home. If you just guys flood the comments for support for Chris, please, he's done a cracking job. Chris, you got anything to round off?
No, I just want to say thanks to all the drivers for turning up week on week. It's been incredible racing. Like I said, there's been some really, really good battles to be watching on the stream, and I think they should all be commended.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, as I say, I can't praise them enough without you know, sounding like I've got my tongue in the wrong place. But they've done a tremendous job, all of you. And again, I think a massive thank you to Chris, a massive thank you to our partners as well, Motorsport Tools, Dwyfer Coffee, O'Shea International, DS Auto Detailing, Boost Energy, and Seren Grace Home Fragrance and Candles. With that said, if you guys in the chat want to say your goodbyes.
Thank you very much.
Cheers, Squid.
Thank you.
Goodbye, Squid.
No problem. No,
thanks ever so much for the commentary, Squid. It's been fantastic.
Oh, it's been fantastic.
Yeah, cheers, Squid. Hopefully we do it again soon.
I hope so too. All right, I'll leave you guys to it then. And what a lovely way to run off a fantastic series. And again, if you want to be part of the action, make sure you hit our Discord link in the description below to join an incredible racing community. Doesn't matter what age, what country, what ability you are, there's something for everyone, there's something for anyone. You're all welcome, Amigos Racing Team. I've been Super Squid. Thanks for taking part in this incredible journey with us over this series, and I hope to see you all very soon. Take care of yourselves and have a wonderful summer.